Hey everybody, welcome back to Long War 2. We've infiltrated this first mission here, and we've done it pretty well, I think. The baseline enemy activity is extremely light, as the early missions will be. And we've infiltrated to 119% to put their readiness at vulnerable. This is the lowest status that it can be, which means we'll face the least amount of enemies possible. And this is the ultimate goal in early missions. We could continue infiltrating up to 200%, but I figure that it's kind of a waste of time to do so. So I've actually stopped it here at 119, and we're gonna launch the mission. The goal is to extract the VIP from the city, and the engineer was up for grabs, Dr. Emeka Jello, and an intel package. So let's go, see how we do. We're taking out three
the priority one transmission from the spokesman.
Squaddies,
the resistance has a VIP operating out of this area in need of immediate extraction. Advent forces are on alert nearby. Be prepared to engage and eliminate any hostile contacts.
You got it, Bradford.
Secure the area and escort the VIP to safety.
Thank you. Pep talk received. So I'm curious, this episode is going to go up kind of near the middle to end of the day on Thursday, which I'm guessing is to when the mod's going to be released. So if you guys have played it, what do you think so far? What are your thoughts? How are you finding it? I'm pretty pumped. It's like new life into XCOM 2, which, to be honest, I still enjoy the vanilla version. So
proceed to the evac volume for extraction.
This is like a sweet dessert.
Advent already knows we're here, so your position isn't concealed for the extraction.
Ooh, we actually have a lot of cool high ground to use. I'm gonna send Raidafuto on a hunt. He's the only one with concealment. And by he, I mean she.
Affirmative. Moving out.
Rabbit's Paw. That's a cool name. Rabbit's Paws are, they considered,
go,
it's a
go.
Symbol of luck or something, right? Rabbit's Paw. Typically, English people would say a rabbit's foot, if I'm not mistaken. Same diff.
Je suis sur le coup.
Yamani, let's head up there.
Good to go.
Emeka, let's keep you below and in the back. And then Heinrich, go right ahead. Just doing mad dashes. We have a limited number of turns. We don't have true concealment, so the counter is going to start right away. I'm sure the true concealment mod would work, but I'm trying to do this like as vanilla Long War as possible, so let's see.
Moving.
Let's move Sakai up a little bit more. Oh, we've got action to the right. You see that? I did.
Look out!
Look at, oh, that's dirty that we can see that.
J'y vais.
I'm gonna just play it cool here. We may reveal them if they come towards us here. These guys are not in concealment, of course, so.
Movement, it's close.
And we've got a group up here. They are coming. This could happen. Ooh, nice.
Position confirmed. Hostile forces spotted.
I love that whisper, that's so cool. Alright, what kind of throw is that? You can't throw it off the ledge? That'd be cool, but okay. I could throw a grenade down there. We'd lose one of the pieces of loot.
Bien reçu. En route vers la cible.
Let's just spread
Moving
these
out.
Guys out a bit.
Okay.
And move Henrik down here. And let's do another round of Overwatch. Let's see what that other group is up to. The challenge here is that if we break the concealment, with Sakai, then these guys are all going to move to the ledge, but it's really, I guess, dependent on where they scatter as to if that's going to be helpful or not. So let's see if we can't go ahead and take out the trooper. The engineer, I believe the engineer launches like flashbangs, if I'm not mistaken. That could be a problem too, but we are using the SMG, so we're not dealing out a ton of damage. As I say that, we get the maximum amount of SMG damage.
Target eliminated.
Generally,
fast.
That was far from a guarantee. Okay. I would like to have eyes on that sectoid. If I don't, I don't feel too bad about it. What I do feel bad about is the fact that this guy could be flanked, and he's not. Okay, so sectoid's right here, because we can't move there. So I'm actually going to drop Imani right down here. And, oh, this could be a cool time to try. Oh, this is cool. Try the shotgun 5-9, or you go both barrels. Okay, so this thing I think we get to use once. If we use this, it probably uses both, right? But look at that, double damage. 10 to 18, that's really cool. And it's 100% because we're right next to them. That's super, that's awesome. Let's do it. Literally blows them away. That's really cool.
What have we got here?
Now, of course, we do have the trooper, and I would have preferred to leave the sectoid alive, but it was too cool not to try it, so.
Bien compris, j'y vais.
Let's see if Otis has anything. 45, it's not great. All these shots are going to be quite poor. I don't want him to, like, flashbang our whole group here, either. We could flashbang him.
Verstanden. Bewege mich zum Ziel.
45, 30, 32. So Otis has pretty good aim, hey? 72. But that high cover, 45, is hurting us. Here's what I can do. I mean, I can take the shot with Otis. And if it doesn't work, it doesn't work. Then we have Lisa, who can flashbang. And we can take another shot with Heinrich, who's slightly better chances to hit. Whoops. So yeah, let's go for it, Otis. See what you got. The graze. All right. I'm gonna see a lot of grazes in Long War 2. Too bad, so sad. Okay, let's flashbang this guy. And then we'll kill him next turn and move on.
Light him up.
Okay, I'll move you up slightly, I guess. We only have 10 turns to get here. We gotta move. Let's see what he decides. Oh, he just froze. Oh, that's too bad. Should I feel bad for the guy? Because I don't. We got two shots here with Imani. Oh my god. Oh, please tell me we have more to look forward to than that, Jelani. Thank you.
Got him.
Seems reasonable. Okay, so Sakai can cover so much ground. I'm gonna hold her back. Let's put Otis down. Nothing spotted.
Moving.
Nothing there. We've got to find this next group so we kind of have an idea of how difficult it's going to be to get to the end, but I'm going to do this. All right, agility, we'll take it. Extra dodge never hurts.
J'ai une cargaison ici.
Roger that.
And as always, we like to take the fancy way to any destination that involves as much workout as possible.
Overwatch! Overwatch!
Bestätigt, Überwachung läuft.
Hunker it down.
Menace 1-5, be advised, hostile interceptors are inbound on your current position. Firebrand has
nothing
a limited
down
window
there?
To
I'm
provide
actually kind
extraction.
Of surprised.
Okay, je me dirige vers la cible.
Gonna bring Jelani way up. Lisa, let's grab cover at the
I'm
edge.
On the move.
8 turns left, which I'm not psyched about.
Orders confirmed, on the move.
But I'm not sure where they're hiding. They're probably camping the objective.
That's affirmative.
So let's maybe move these guys up
okay.
A bit.
Covering now.
Come on. Full cover boom booms. Nothing. That worries me. That worries me greatly.
Closing on target position now. Heading there now.
Let's keep you behind our crew here.
Moving to designated position.
Otis, go ahead and grab the full cover.
Je confirme la position.
Yeah, here we go.
Force d'advent dans le
secteur. Oh! Alright. Here we go. This is where things get tough. Giant group like this, 5 of them. Behind the objective. Let's just get you into a better position for next time. Can't really do much there, other than maybe flashbang, which I think
better
we will do.
Eyes.
And these are all really low chances as well. Let's just drop down an overwatch. Actually, let's get you reloaded for next turn. We might have a couple of shots.
Back online.
We could, and I probably should have actually used this flashbang so we can launch a little bit further. Let's be cool. Let's work our way out of this. Feeling very confident against my overwatches. That's great. Uh-oh. We've been banged.
What?
Repeat. We've been banged. Engineer has banged us. I'm nervous. Everybody on the field's disoriented pretty much. Where's this guy going? I don't trust him. Sentry? Uh-oh.
I just
give it a
go.
Try.
Do that then.
Alright. Who's overwatched here? Just this dude, hey? Oh, that is so unfortunate. Do I just say forget it? You know what? Oh, we can't use the sword anyway. We could do this. But they're both carrying gear. That's the downside. But we only have 6 turns to make something happen here. It's not a small amount of time, but this guy being on an overwatch really kind of hampers us if that's something we're worried about, which I kind of am, considering that I've got a bunch of people flashbanged that really can't do anything. So maybe this is their time to just say, you know what, I'm gonna maybe take one for the team here. I'm gonna dash. I'm gonna break that Overwatch with Raito Futo. Oh, you know what? Hold on. Yeah, let's do it.
Affirmative.
Over here. Beautiful. We might not have the luxury of trying to save all that loot. I think with Jelani, we want to do something similar where we're kind of flanking a group. Even if we're sitting in half cover.
Copy that.
Get her ready to take two shots next time. Otis, however, we can flank now. We could probably kill the engineer. I'd be sitting in half cover for the sentry. We have this option, or we have the option of throwing the grenade. But if we're gonna launch the grenade anyways, it's a tough call. Let's take out this guy, hopefully. Oh my god, 80s are missing.
Allez, concentre-toi.
80s are missing.
J'aurai bientôt plus de munitions.
Lisa. Confirmed. Moving out.
The rookie. It hurts almost. It really hurts.
Yeah, I didn't get it.
All right. Full cover back here for you.
Drücke zur Zielposition vor.
I hate to do it. Is that wasteful? Like, what's... You know what? Maybe we just re-flashbang this group and hit the engineer this time. I'd really like to try and get as much of this loot as possible. A couple of unfortunate misses here. I'm hoping that it reapplies the time, even though it says... Okay, good. It's not saying they're not disoriented anymore. Good, good. So it did reapply it, even though it doesn't show. Oh, if he mind controls here. I think he failed it. Oh, maybe we're... Yeah, I think he failed it. Everybody's missing everything. 6 turns left. These guys should be missing because they're all confused. I'm a bit worried about this dude. Where's he going? Wow, it's ballsy. Okay, well, forget him.
Okay then.
Okay, disorientation removed. Good. Good, good, good. Now let's make dreams come true here. I cannot reach the sectoid, unfortunately. This guy we should be able to hit at some point. He's causing us a lot of problems. Oh, he's Overwatch too. I think I'm still gonna go for it. He is disoriented. So let's make our move. Oh yeah, so are we. Great. Well, we're gradually moving people closer to the objective. The chances of these guys hitting Overwatches is super low. So we've got full cover there. I'm trying, really trying not to blow these guys up, but if we're not gonna kill them anyways.
Understood. Moving out.
And what's the difference, right? Chances are really bad. Okay. We could reapply it again to these three. We could bring you... Bring you inside. Let's bring you in there. It's full cover. Let's overwatch up top. I think we'll reapply the flashbang here. And with the grenade, let's just hold on to it.
Affirmative, covering now.
Grenade flash.
Whew. We got 233s with Imani if we want them. I think I'm just gonna move them a little closer to the objective.
Moving out.
And we'll take one. The thing is, this guy, counting his lucky stars, because he is just surviving. We still have Henrik here. Let's start bringing him over. And it seems crazy, but we're just gonna kill this guy. I don't want to deal with him at all. We're gonna have four more turns to execute this. Maybe this is a bit greedy trying to get all this loot instead of just killing these guys outright, but we're keeping them flashbanged and they're not doing a great job of killing us, so.
Adjusting aim.
He's gonna bring him right back. But guess what? I think we've got a little shinobi action waiting for you. I'm hoping that we lose that disorientation, we can kill the sectoid with Lucky Foot.
Das war knapp.
Flash banged for days. This guy, this is my biggest worry. This sentry's gonna...
Yeah, I didn't get it.
Snark somebody, I think. Oh, beautiful. Okay, disorientation removed, finally. Can I kill this guy? I can, most likely. 7-9, ugh, we know how that's gonna go. But then you're sitting right in the open too. Like, we don't have a great spot. Well, actually, hold on. I can do it from here. I mean, they can move into flanking positions. I'm going for it. Looks like he still lives, which I don't like. Oh, you've got to be joking! Oh my god.
Adjusting sights.
That's insane. That's insane. Okay.
Moving to designated position. Well,
let's bring Lisa in. We'll try this again. Same path. Really don't want to have to kill the zombie. Like, I almost think... You know, we've tried it. tried to get as much of this loot as possible. We still do have four turns, but it's getting increasingly more difficult.
Position confirmed.
And I think it's time that we just say, you know what? You guys have been around long enough. And we just go for it. They don't want to blow that wall down, believe it or not, but...
He is finished!
Sorry, boys. Loot destroyed.
Mehrere Ziele ausgeschaltet.
Now, I do want to go ahead, flashbang this sectoid if I can.
Blinding them.
Get rid of that zombie. But Sakai is in trouble for sure. Okay, let's do this. Let's get Emeka way up there. We still have Otis. If I overwatch him, it's gonna discourage the sentry from moving in. And maybe the sectoid from moving in as well. With Lisa, we could just take the shot, hope for the best. Oh, beautiful! That's what I'm talking about.
Nailed him.
Squad's coming through and it counts.
Oh, no,
that's what matters. And now, I just want to position us. I want to keep that guy kind of pinned, but... Be cool, sectoid. Be cool. Be cool. Oh! That's right, you can't
fire.
See anything. All right, well.
Menace 1-5, hostile interceptors are on high speed approach. Your window for extraction is closing.
I'm doing this. I believe that we're gonna hit it at one point. Finally.
It's down.
Okay, so we lost a couple of pieces of loot. Here. But man, were we missing a lot of shots. And a lot of sword attacks. Let's be honest, the sword misses, they don't really surprise
me.
But we also did it without taking any casualties.
Copy that.
We did take somebody. Oh, did we get through scot-free?
Okay, bin unterwegs.
Yeah, we got through scot-free.
Rolling out.
All right, you get out of here.
VIP,
you get out of here. Gone. Gone.
Just in time.
Gone.
I'm out of here.
And lastly, let's go. That was close. You know what's funny is, like, normally in that situation, I would blast that grenade, like, no questions asked, right? Because not, like, everything is carrying loot, but when they've got that loot marker, you really makes you reconsider, like, oh, do I want to do it or not? I tried to hold out as long as possible. Just felt like we kept making those misses, and then we had Sakai in, like, a tough spot. So, tough call, but squad's safe.
Executed to the highest standards. Excellent work, Commander.
Okay, that's great. So, new promotions. Now, what do we got here? Infantry, all Like, perks have been reworked too, so this is going to be a whole learning experience. He's got close and personal, which confers 30 crit damage, bonus to climbs with distance. Okay. Against adjacent targets. Bonus is reduced by 5% for each additional tile of distance from the target, down to 0% at 7 or more tiles. Huh. Okay, so basically the closer that you get, the more crit chance. Fair enough. I just feel like with a ranger, it's kind of hard to do that. Take a highly accurate shot with plus 30 bonus to hit, but for half damage and minus 30 crit, uses 2 ammo. So, early game, crappy. Late game, could be great. And covering fire, Overwatch shots can now be triggered by any enemy action, not just movement. This is actually not a bad call, but let's think about that for a second. His chance to hit right now, it's 65. If an enemy's in cover, let's say reduce it by 30, he's at 35. If you take an Overwatch shot, even if the enemy doesn't move, they're still in that cover. So, like, if they're just shooting. So, what am I gaining from that currently? That's a tough one, man. I think I'm going to take the extra bonus to hit, even if it's half damage. Yeah, let's do that. Alright, so we've got another specialist. Very nice. Our Grenadier is up to Sapper, so your explosive can destroy many cover objects. We've got Needle Grenades, which means your explosives do not destroy loot when they kill enemies. Ooh! And then Rapid Deployment. If we activate this before throwing or launching a support grenade, and the throw will not cost an action. So smokes, flashbangs, battle scanners. You could throw that for free, basically. Right? Huh, that's cool. Throw that and then launch a regular grenade. I like needle grenades right now, though. Especially if we run into these troopers that are carrying gear, we just boom, needle grenade, down. Early game, I think that's great. Slash, okay, Ghost Walker. So this reduces the enemy detection range around you. Low profile makes low cover count as full. And then Cutthroat. Your melee attacks against biological enemies ignore armor, have a plus 15 crit chance, and do 2 critical damage. I mean, I wish we could get both of these. Tough decision, but I think we'll take the extra damage right now and ignoring armor. Actually, maybe not. Because we can attack from over low cover like we just did in that last scenario. And it would count as full. But if we're attacking from that close anyways, then they could just walk around anywhere and flank us. So I'm actually going to take Cutthroat. And then another technical class. Beautiful, because explosives is helpful. Nice. We got Engineer, right? I believe so. There we go. So why don't we put you in the Guerrilla Tactics School? Try and speed that up, knock it down to 4 days. Let's go back here and see how many missions we run into. Oh, nice. Okay. After a recent success, we can get a resistance mech. How does that work, I wonder? Another mission. Jeez. Here we go. Told ya. Okay, so this one is rescuing resistance contacts. Okay, these are super cool missions. Basically, you have to go in and like break them out of like prison cells, and then you have to escort all of them to the evac zone. So that's really cool. Extremely light base activity, but we're definitely going to go and send an infiltration squad. The nice thing about only getting that one mission earlier was that pretty much everybody's ready to go again if we so chose to do so. We could definitely send out a couple of these guys once again. Let's send out Raito Futo. Um, Just trying to think. If we got to get them and then we got to get to the evac, we want mobile soldiers. I even think the ranger is kind of hampered in that scenario because you want to be moving, shooting, moving, shooting, moving, shooting. Let's take our technical class here in Bull. Let's go ahead and take out... we have two specialists now. Let's take out Otis again. And... let's see, what's our time? See, now, this is where it gets crazy, okay? We've only got 3 days to infiltrate. And just with these three soldiers, we're already over the infiltration time. So getting to 100%, probably not gonna happen. But then it's like, well, do you wanna take... Here's the thing, we could just not go on this mission, and that could be a thing. Or you could take a more like really direct approach and like not do it, like not go for as many kills and just go and get the guys, try and get out as quickly as you can, maybe taking cover and stuff like that. That could be a thing. Because the way that mission XP works is a little bit differently now. It gets distributed equally among your team. So there's probably a little bit more to that. I should read more about it, but mission XP is awarded a bit differently. So you could get away with doing something like that and still get some experience. We can get close to 100% with this squad. Shinobi, some explosives, which is obviously hurting us a little bit. We could maybe ditch some of the flashbangs, but it could be quite helpful if we have to stay in a spot. We could try it with three soldiers, that's risky. Let's take out another rookie. We're not going to be able to infiltrate to 100%, but we can at least do something. Let's look at our weapon upgrades. I do believe we've got that stock. We've got the hair trigger. ...25 aim, 25 crit chance. Who do we want to equip that on? I'm not sure. I don't think we need to give those upgrades to any of these guys. Let's do this with four. We're not going to infiltrate to 100%.
Sky Ranger
in position for deployment.
Okay, start the infiltration. Boom, here come all the missions. Now we have Guerrilla Ops. Extremely light, hacking the workstation, so we need our specialists. 25 intel. Yeah, it's okay. But look at this. 1 day and 4 hours? That's insane. And this is why you want to have people in your haven on intel, I think, so that you can detect these missions earlier so that they don't expire so quick. I feel like if we go on this mission, it's going to be extremely difficult because the soldiers are going to, like, boost themselves up, right? 1 day, 4 hours. It's only 25 intel as well, so I actually think we're going to let that one expire. And, like, you're not supposed to go on every mission. You just can't. That's the one we're going to let go. It's 25 intel. We already have 125. Not that we don't need it, but I think our efforts are better spent elsewhere instead of sending people into that death trap. So while this is happening, let's try and go down and grab this mech. All right. So what does this say? Not much is left to salvage from the craft, but our team discovered an intact, powered down Advent mech in a cargo pod thrown clear of the crash. We're able to reset its programming and direct it to obey XCOM resistance personnel, and it will be transferred to a nearby haven to assist in its defense. Oh, cool. Oh, look, resistance mechs. Okay, cool. So if this haven gets attacked, which I'm sure at some point it definitely will, then we have a mech there that's gonna, like, defend. That's super cool. That's awesome. Let's just go back here and we'll just scan a bit. Okay, alien biotech done.
The advent officers have clearly been modified to allow AP for rounds? Their subordinates to receive new orders psionically. The implanted chip is the key.
So these bypass enemy armor, we haven't seen a lot of armor. We see them on like the drones and stuff right now. There's the other things that you can do called rendering corpses, which basically means instead of like selling corpses like we would do previously, you can render them down for alloys. So Trooper gives us 2 alloys, you can see in the bottom of the description there. Officer would give us 3, and Sectoid Corpse would give us 3. You probably have this option with all types of corpses that you find. But for now, we're gonna go into resistance comms, I think. Battle scanner would be nice too. Let's do this. Let's get resistance comms up so we can start expanding, potentially getting more missions, etc., etc.
I'll have a report assembled as soon as the research is complete.
Guerrilla Tactics School now operational.
Okay, that's also awesome. So we've got 2 slots for soldiers now. Let's start throwing in some of our rookies here. Training times are 7 days. I like the Shinobi, a lot of damage output. The Grenadiers obviously are nice. Let's maybe take our assault class. Get some shotguns going. Emma Doyle, let's throw you in there. Let's go... Gunner? Yeah, let's do a gunner. And then we could also put people in for officer training. We could buy a station for 35 supplies. I'm actually going to do this.
Facility upgraded.
And who would be a good officer? Heinrich could be. It's tough to say early. I'm just trying to think of like who's going to be around like the middle of the squad because they have like an area that they can impact. I think let's throw Heinrich in there. So he's got Oscar Mike, where you can spend an action to give all 3 allies within command range plus 3 mobility for the remainder of the turn. Okay, that's cool. What's leadership history? Oh, neat. And then focus fire. Spend an action to pinpoint a target and grant your squad cumulative aim bonuses and 1 armor piercing on attacks against that target. Yes, let's take that. All right, in here we've got Vengeance, we got Wet Work. We have really no supplies to buy this stuff. Tactical infiltrations. Infiltrations for squads of 6 or 7 soldiers will take less time. Special requirement, this upgrade requires an officer of at least major rank. Okay. Large unit infiltrations, 8 to 10 soldiers will take less time. This upgrade requires an officer of at least colonel rank. Wow, okay. So those are new. Everything else is straightforward. Like, so intense. At least for me, it's like overwhelming. All right, so current enemy activity is very light. They are guarded, which is like the third or I think it's like the third one up from the bottom. Vulnerable, normal, guarded, maybe. We definitely want to get these guys to join our haven. There's 3 people in there, it looks like. Let's see again. So Chica, Ola Bode. Okay, it's 2. So we get 2 resistance people to join our haven, which would be good because then we can assign them to do like supply gathering or intel or what have you. Shambling Dirge. Yeah, let's go. I guess this is where we end the episode because we've already set up the squad, so it's a bit of a weird thing for me. I normally end my episodes right after we set up the squad, but when we come back, we'll be going out to West Africa on Operation Shambling Dirge. Wish me luck, guys. We'll see you later, and take care. Bye.
The world you once knew is no more. Earth is now ruled by the Advent Coalition and their alien masters.